Hi everybody, Emma here. First and foremost, I'd like to thank you very much for your comments, likes, questions, just any feedback that you gave last week to the concentration tips video. It's very much appreciated. We really look forward to hearing what you guys have to say. So yeah, thank you very, very much. And make sure you do the same with this video, okay? So underneath, just write us a comment and really appreciate it. Okay, well, this week, as last week's concentration tips were the basics, which are important, remember, so we don't want to forget the basics, but they were a little bit generic. So this week we're going to advance a little bit and we're going to talk about more specialised concentration tips. So some, you know, more specialist kind of focused advice on ways that you can improve how you work, your time management and how to concentrate in general. So this week we're going to talk about the Pomodoro technique. Now some of you might have heard of this. It was founded in the late 1980s, so been around quite a while now, and some people rate it very, very highly and say that it really, really helps them. So I wanted to tell you guys about it. Now for those of you who don't know about it, it's basically a time management system that people use when they work. And it basically breaks your time where you work into 25-minute slots. And after each 25-minute slot, you have a 5-minute break. So you have 25 minutes working, and then you have a 5-minute interval. And that is the basic idea of it. But there are certain steps to the Pomodoro technique, which you need to know if you want to do it properly. So I'm going to run through those quickly with you guys. Okay, so step one. On a piece of paper, just write down all the tasks that you have to do. Write them in a little list and have next to them a space, because you're going to have to mark off what you've done each time. So a list of what you need to do and in terms of what's the most important, so prioritise this list. Okay, so that's step one. Now step two, set your timer to 25 minutes. Now it's called the Pomodoro technique because Pomodoro means tomato in Italian. And they used a kitchen timer shaped like a tomato, so that's why it's called that. So you can use a kitchen timer, or you can use your phone or your computer or whatever you want, but set it to 25 minutes. Step three, work on the task until the 25 minutes is up and your timer rings. Now, as soon as the timer rings, make sure you stop. That's very important. Okay, and then make sure you mark next to your task with an X after your first 25 minutes. And you'll soon learn that after every 25 minutes, you have to mark an X. Okay, step four, take a short break. So you take a 5-minute break and do something that doesn't take up too much mental capacity. So just relax or do whatever, but nothing too, you know, mentally straining, shall we say. And step five is that on every fourth interval, you have to have a longer break. So after you've done 3 5-minute breaks, the fourth one should be around 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, those are your steps. Now there's a few simple rules. First of all, once the timer goes off, make sure you stop. Even if you feel like if you had 2 more minutes, you'd be able to finish, just stop. That's how the system works, and you must be quite strict with yourself and make sure that you follow the system properly. Now also, during the break, as I said, don't do anything which takes up too much mental thought. And also, if the 25-minute duration where you're working becomes interrupted, then make sure that you count that 25 minutes as void. Okay? So, unfortunately, yeah, you just have to get rid of that 25 minutes. It didn't exist. And you start over again. And this is all, you know, for your benefit as well. So, it may seem a little bit strange, but that's the best way for the Pomodoro technique to work. Now, basically, what some of the principles are, you know, I said you have to mark an X when you've done 25 minutes. This is to create the feeling of accomplishment. So it's encouraging for you to feel like you've achieved something. Okay, so just when you mark your X after every 25 minutes, you will slowly begin to feel like you're accomplishing something, which is encouraging, and everybody needs encouragement now and again. So also, each small break is basically allowing the mind to refocus and recuperate after concentrating for 25 minutes solid. And that is the idea behind the Pomodoro technique, is that you're giving your brain a chance to rest and refocus, and then that means that you're going to stay refreshed and you're going to be able to concentrate for longer. So that's basically the principle behind the Pomodoro technique, and it's supposed to improve your mind's agility, and a lot of people really do recommend this. We have people who use it and they say that it really improves how they work. You get a lot more done because you're aware that you've got 25 minutes. So you try and fit in as much as you can to that 25 minutes. So it has a lot of positive effect on a lot of people. So I suggest that you guys try it. And however you find it, just let us know, because we want to hear what you think so that we can pass the message on again. So tell us if you liked it, if you hated it, if you haven't got used to it. Apparently it takes around 2 days of using this technique to become fully accustomed to it and fully used to it. So I think it is something which you have to, you know, use habit in. You have to get used to it. So bear that in mind if it's first day, you're struggling a little bit. Now, if you would like to try this and you don't have a kitchen timer or whatever you need, then I would suggest downloading an app on your computer called the Focus Booster. Now, the Focus Booster is basically like a countdown app so that you can just have on your desktop or whatever, or hidden if you don't want to look at it all the time, counting down. And you can set it to 25 minutes, and then you can do your own Pomodoro technique with the Focus Booster app. So bear that in mind. I'll try and put a link in the description, so look that up. But that's all for this week, and please let us know what you think about the Pomodoro technique, if you've used it before or if anyone else has, and if not, if you're going to try it now, then please let us know in the comments below. Also, a big ask, can you please like us on Facebook, Concentration Music and Relaxing Records? That'd be awesome. And make sure you subscribe to this channel, because we're going to have loads more tips and loads more specialised advice coming up for you guys really, really soon. Okay, so let me know what you think, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye, guys.